Welcome to Ashthorne Gaming, and this is the new touchHLE iPhone emulator, currently exclusive to Windows and Mac OS. We're going to be running it on the Steam Deck, but Linux desktop users can also follow along. So first we need to be on desktop mode. We'll start by downloading the latest Windows build of the touchHLE emulator, and once we're finished downloading it, we're going to extract it. Once we've done that, we're going to locate the IPA file of the app you're trying to run and copy it to the same folder as the emulator's executable. Now we're going to open Steam. Add a non-Steam game and navigate to the emulator's executable. We'll add it to our Steam library and right-click on the name of the program. Click on Properties. Then we're going to navigate to the Compatibility tab to check the box that enables use of the Proton compatibility tool. I'll be using Proton Experimental, but it'll likely work with older builds. Now we're going to navigate back to the General tab and copy the line in the Launch Options. We're then going to add a space after the line and paste the copy. Rename the executable name at the end of the line to the name of the game's IPA file we've copied into the emulator's folder earlier. Then we're going to add a space and copy the set scale line from the app support page and paste it. Add a 2 to the end of it, which will adjust the emulator's resolution to properly fit the screen of the Steam Deck. Now for Super Monkey Ball specifically, there's an additional command we have to add to fix the in-game tilting controls, otherwise you can't tilt back. We'll copy the tilt control fix line from the README, add another space to the launch options line, and paste it there. The touchHLE developer mentions that they'll have this set by default in a later version, but for now we have to fix it manually. Quick note for some apps that may need to have the screen tilted manually, such as Crash Bandicoot Nitro Kart 3D. The app support document gives a fix, and it can be applied just like the tilt fix. Now we're good to go, and we'll go back into gaming mode and try this emulator out. As you can see, the emulator is running the game perfectly at a stable 30 FPS, no dips whatsoever. So there you have it, enjoy your 32-bit iOS apps on the Steam Deck as more become compatible over time. Bye for now. Go!